guys, it is Vlogmas. I want to apologize to you guys so much. I've been trying to get videos up, and my freaking iMovie and my Mac have just been acting so crazy. I think I'm on overload. I think my computer's on overload because you guys know it's finals. So I've been, like, doing my study guides. I took my final. And I think between me trying to do my final and also, like, edit videos almost every day, I think it got to the point where my computer is just acting dumb. So hopefully this Vlogmas can go up today. As you guys can see, I am in a different environment. This is not my car. Long story short, about 2 months ago, I did have a collision. Everyone was safe, but it's been taking so long. As many of you guys know, I have a Chevy Blazer. I got my Chevy Blazer in March, the end of March 2019. And because the car is so new, and number two, GM had a strike, that's why it's been taking them so long to freaking get the parts. So I think my collision was in October. So if some of you guys, like, watch me in October, you might have noticed I was a little off, and I was also having issues with consistency because there were so much things going on. But it is what it is. It's getting fixed, so I am in a rental. They gave me a Hyundai Sonata, Elantra, something like that. I don't know. But I'll take whatever the insurance pays for at this moment. I don't understand how I turn in a Blazer and get a car. And we had our first snow here in Jersey. But God willing, it's not supposed to snow anymore. And I also, it is what it is. I kind of don't even, like, my mood gets so trash when I talk about it because I'm still pissed. About that, but things happen, and like I said, as long as everyone's okay, that's the main theory. But it's taken so long, guys, to get to this point. I'm just grateful that my truck is there and it's gonna get fixed and I can move on. So anywho, I'm getting ready to, I was gonna take my rental books back because, as you guys know, we're at the end of the semester, but I decided to come home real quick because I do have to get, like, laundry and stuff done, and I want to see if this morning my computer will actually let me freaking edit. I had to actually post a video yesterday because the week had went by, it's already Tuesday, I had no video up, and I've been promising you guys, even though I wasn't going to do every day of Vlogmas, I would have at least 2 vlogs a week along with a formal upload. So because I have all this footage and I couldn't like edit, I had to post a video that I had pre-uploaded for the end of the month yesterday. So that is, I'll put that in the tag above. It actually is a good video. My 2-year update as a nurse, I really want to do it at the end of the year, but things happen for a reason. So I'm gonna go ahead and see if I can maybe edit anything else. I do still want to get my holiday gift video up, and then I have a lot of vlogging footage. Like, I don't even know what to do at this point. I don't know if I should scratch the footage or if I should just try to incorporate it, because I feel like it's not really real vlogs if it's not, like, daily things happening. But I don't know, it still was, like, some interesting stuff going on and something for you guys to watch. Right now I'm drinking this. Supposedly Burger King doesn't sell iced coffee, so I got a caramel frap. When I tell y'all, this girl put this whole freaking caramel in this thing, like, my blood sugar right now is probably like 560, I swear, because this thing has so much caramel, especially in the middle. But anywho, guys, I got a sandwich for me, I got a sandwich for my mom from Burger King, so I'm gonna head in. I just wanted to kind of update you guys, and hopefully I'll be able to get this vlog up. Ugh. Caramel's on my hands. That's how much daggone caramel she put in this thing.
Okay, guys, we're back home. I promised that I was actually going to show you guys how I do my typical Christmas baskets that I make for some of my friends and family members. I found that this has been a very good idea because I just like being creative, one, and two, it's super simple, it's super cheap, and you can put all their stuff in one thing, and you don't have to like get a Christmas bag or anything like that. So I'm gonna show you guys one that I made first for my Secret Santa, and then I'm going to actually go ahead and do one on camera. I'm praying my camera is like on freaking what now, 70%? I hope it stays alive just so I can show you guys this. If not, I might have to grab my phone in between, but that's okay. So right now, I'm just gonna move a little bit. As you guys can see, our tree is getting full. So this is one of the baskets I made. This was for my Secret Santa at work. So, kind of just took into account all the things that were important. You guys can see whoever I got, they definitely like baby sharks. So I went ahead and got those items. I took into account their size, their age, everything like that. And I made the basket. So this basket is the whole thing and it's super cute. I'm going to go ahead and grab the ones from the back. I'll tell you guys where I got the materials. And I'll show you guys how we wrap it. All right, guys, I moved myself out the frame real quick so you guys can just see the basket. So basically, you want to take into account everything this person likes. So for example, I have some Bath and Body Works in here. I had like a sweater. I got a tin to hold some gift cards, some fuzzy socks, and then I think there's like some hot cocoa. So this basket came from Hobby Lobby. It was only, I think, $3 or $4. These things are very inexpensive to make. This was $3 or $4. The one I showed you guys in the previous clip for the kids basket was only $1 from Dollar Tree. So I usually just, depending on the age, I kind of go out and try to look for a nice bucket. But this one is literally perfect from Hobby Lobby. So the next thing, of course, you're going to need is a basket bag. So these basket bags are also from Dollar Tree. They are only $1. I always get the one that comes with one bag and it's shrink wrap and pull bow because it will fit around the basket more shaped like the one I showed you guys in the previous clip. And it also comes with a pull bow at the top. They do sell another pack. I think it has red trim and you get two bags. The only thing with that basket is when you get the two bags, you cannot shrink wrap it. You have to kind of like make it fit to shape. So it's a little bit harder. It does work best for really big baskets because if you already have a big basket, you really don't need to make it shape out. And what I usually do when I have that one is I have to tape to shape it out. But this one's perfect. Shrink wrap, all you need literally is a blow dryer and you're set. So we're gonna go ahead and open this. I'm trying to decide. I don't want to do a voiceover in a vlog for you guys, but I know once I start wrapping the bag and everything like that, it's gonna get super noisy. And I know that can be very, like, disturbing as far as noise. So we'll see. But we'll go ahead and go as far as we can. And if I have to do a voiceover, that's cool. So like I said, guys, this is very inexpensive. You literally, even if you have, like, a price limit on somebody, like, say you don't want to spend more than, like, $40 or $50, get a list from them, even if it's, like, Pollyanna or something, of things they like. And then you just go from there. So you guys see I have the plastic. This is the bag. This is the bow, which I will show you guys how that works later. Every time I open these packs each year, I have to remind myself how the bow works. It's too funny. All right. So we're gonna take our bag. Like how I just did pick it up a little bit. This bag is strong enough to hold this basket already. So if you have to pick it up a little bit, that's fine. So looking at it right now, typically if this was the one I couldn't shrink wrap, I would have to go on the sides and tape this edge down. But as soon as I get everything squared away, I'm going to try to shrink wrap that. So you have your basket in here. Next thing I focus on is bringing the top together. We're gonna do next, guys, is we're gonna go right into the blow dryer and try to get it as formed as possible to this basket, and then we'll see what I have to do at the top and with the bow. So stay tuned. Okay, so as you guys can see through blow drying, I've got it pretty tight knit to the basket. There's some other areas I'll go back across when I'm done. So the next thing you want to do is now that you have your top, you want your top to stay as neat as possible up in this area. And now I'm going to show you guys kind of the bow. So you have two options. Some people will rubber band the top. Some people will staple the top. Especially when it comes to kids, like when I did the kid basket, I didn't want to put staples or anything in it. So I literally stapled it and then pulled the staples out after I was done. This basket is super easy because it doesn't have a lot going on at the top. So I might be able to bow tie it without having to staple it at the top. But if you're a beginner, I encourage you to use a rubber band or that. Next I'm going to show you guys this bow. So I know you're looking like, what the heck is this? This is not a bow. When you get this package, I want you to find the strings that are inside. I literally want you to take the strings and hold them like this and just pull away from the strings, if you guys can see. So literally I have the strings here, I'm pulling away and kind of just making sure this is straightened out too, because this gets a little weird. Pulling away from the strings. And there you go, you have your bow. And then what you can do is, once you have it like this, this is like the orientation, you can tie it around the top of the basket. All right guys, I had to transfer you over to the phone because of course the camera died and my phone is also dying. This is like ridiculous, but I got the bow tied on the top, and like I told you guys, you have these extra strings here. So one thing you can use the extra strings to do is actually to tighten the top, because I don't like how the top looks right now. I like it when it's like a fluffy kind of top, if you have some top left. So I'm gonna go around maybe once or twice with these strings. That's the thing I worry about the most. So after I've wrapped it around a few times, I'm gonna go in and tie. And I hate this because I feel like you guys can't really see what I'm doing, but it's okay. It's okay. We have our strings here, so I'm going to get my scissors. And another thing, too, I think I forgot to mention to you guys, inside the basket at the bottom, to give it a little bit more, like, full, I do have some of that red little, I actually see some on the floor in the living room, my mom's probably going to kill me. Like the little red basket stuffing. I forget what it's exactly called, but you can find that at Dollar Tree. And they also had it in Hobby Lobby while I was in there. So I'm gonna pull these strings a little bit just to curl them out. If any of you guys wrap presents or anything or do decorations, you know the trick for curling streamers. If I can find a video here on YouTube to attach to supplement this, but you literally just take the inside of your scissors very carefully and you go down the strings to cut them. We're gonna go ahead and blow dry some more, and then we'll get this tightened up and I will show you guys the after effect. So I'm liking it right now. The only thing I'm gonna tell you guys is I like this thing at the top to be extravagant, so it can be like a basket. But I think by tightening it up around the edges, once you get the blow dryer again, it'll help. So I'm gonna bring this in a little bit closer for you guys. As you can see, that's the basket finished. The top, when you get to the top, I always blow dry towards the bow. That's another way to make this area look more prominent, and that's what I was talking about earlier. So this looks amazing. I think I have to tighten up the bottom a little bit more, guys, but that is pretty much how I do my Christmas baskets. And they get to open them. These are good for kids because kids get to like take the wrapping off. The only thing with kids, I know they can see some of their presents in here, but any of their little like stocking stuffers, or I know like when Santa comes, Santa leaves some of the stuff out. You can literally put what Santa leaves in here for them so that it's not just sitting like out in the tree or in front of them. So anywho guys, that is basically me doing a quick basket. Like I said, it's super cheap. The basket only cost me like $3 or $4 and it's super cute. The bag is $1 in Dollar Tree. Y'all know I love Dollar Tree. And it's a simple way to just make sure you're showing somebody, hey, I'm thinking about you at Christmas time. And I got a bunch of your goodies in here, but I also put some little creativeness into it. I love this time of year because I feel like ways I can't be creative, I can go ahead and be creative during the Christmas time. So this is one of the things I like to do. I also do these baskets throughout the year as people request them for like birthdays, baby showers, Things like that. Same mechanism. I get my material normally from Dollar Tree, Hobby Lobby, Michaels, AC Moore, and I just love doing the baskets. I think they're a really nice gift.
All right, guys, so as you can see, I've already got the rest of my Christmas gifts pretty much stuffed with paper and wrapped up. I did not do any wrapping paper this year. This hair is so tragic, y'all. This hair. I'm telling y'all, I'm very, very much struggling. If you watched in my last Vlogmas, you know what's going on right now, so please excuse it. But anywho, I'm going to go ahead and film the outro right here. I don't even know if you need an official outro for a Vlogmas. New YouTuber problems. But I know my phone is dying, the camera's dead, and... I hope you guys enjoyed. So again, I'll include down in the description box all the material you need to make these baskets. It's a perfect Christmas gift idea for someone who's close to you, even for somebody who you're not that close to, but you need a simple, straightforward gift. I think the baskets are amazing. Like I said, I do these throughout the year for like baby showers, birthday parties, etc. If I can include some pictures, I made a really good football one time too. Maybe I'll try to put them at the end of the vlog. But if not, you guys, it's super easy. If you're creative and you like your creative side, go ahead and get these materials because it will save you a lot of time, and it'll let you express yourself during Christmas. So, anywho, I will see you guys in the next Vlogmas. Everybody enjoy your day and stay safe. Bye.